Hello, MJ7NLK here, and welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we are looking at the Radioddity CS-47, a tiny CB radio which costs around £70. This radio has NRC and CTCSS and DCS tones and codes, and is expandable. Before we dive in, some radio news. I have just received the new Zhigu X6200, which is their latest HF all-mode transceiver. It outputs 5 watts when running on battery and 8 watts when powered externally, and has a built-in antenna tuner. This is a beast of a radio, which we will be looking at very soon. Coming up in this video, unboxing and first look, size and price comparison, general radio operation, standard power tests, modifying the radio, and expanded power tests. There is lots to cover, so please do stick around. Before we continue, here is a quick message from this video's sponsor, PCBWay. PCBWay are makers of prototype PCBs of all kinds. They also offer services like PCB assembly, CNC machining, 3D printing, sheet metal fabrication, and injection molding. Manufacturing times are exceptionally quick and delivery is super fast. I have used their services on many occasions, and PCBWay get an NLK-Media thumbs up for quality and service. Check out their website, PCBWay.com, for more information or follow the link in the video's description. PCBWay are running a 10th anniversary special event and you can claim prizes and badges, so it's worth a look. Check that link out in the video description as well. Thank you, PCBWay, for supporting this channel. Let's take a quick look at the box. Well, it's a small, almost cube-like block of cardboard. Nothing to see here. So let's move on and see what's inside. We get a very thin user manual, an accessories pouch, the microphone, the usual pack of mic clip screws and spare fuse, a painted mounting bracket, that's nice to see. Let's have a quick look at the microphone. This has a RJ45 style connector, and it's got a nice click to it with up-down buttons on the top. We'll have a good look at that when we run through the general radio operation, but that looks quite nice. And then moving over to the radio. Oh my goodness. This thing is tiny. Yeah, that's what she said. Having a quick look around the radio, there is no display on the front. It is all contained within the microphone. And we have the connector. Nothing on the sides. Tiny little speaker on the bottom. A reasonable heatsink at the back. This certainly has vibes of the Bill 2. And fixed power connector with an accessories socket. And we have an external speaker. So that is absolutely tiny. Let's compare it to the Bill 2. So here is the Bill 2. Comparing them side by side, there are certainly some similarities here. The heatsink has one more fin by the look of it compared to the Bill. The Bill has a slight cutout, but it looks like they've come from the same factory. They are very, very similar indeed. Let's open them up and have a look and compare them inside. As with the Bill 2, the CS47 uses a Torx T8H bit in order to remove the screws. So let me go ahead and get these undone on both units and we'll have a look at the boards. Well, they're very, very similar inside. The CS47 has a dummy speaker grill. There is no speaker. That's because it comes out the microphone, which we'll have a look at in a short while. But internally, these radios are really very, very similar. The expansion options for the Bill 2 are very inconveniently located down here. And on the CS47, they are very conveniently located right here. The jumper and also the loop wire. You can see the similarities within these radios. You can see on the finals and also on the shielding. They are extremely similar internally. So the Bill 2 is £115 and the Radioddity is £70. The Bill 2 does not have NRC, but it does have ANL noise blanker and high cut filters, and there's no CTCSS on this radio. The base of the Bill 2 is metal, certainly feels metal, and the base of the CS-47 is very much plastic. So before we weigh them, the Bill 2 has a slightly smaller screen than the CS-47. This is slightly larger than the screen on the radio itself. And the bill weighs in at 330 grams, as near as damn it. And the CS-47 276. And before anybody complains about weighing it without the microphone, the Bill 2 as a total package, if you're carting this thing around, is 467 grams. And the CS-47 is 464 grams. So why is the weight important? Why am I bothering weighing these things? Well, the Bill is a very popular bug-out radio, and the CS-47 could be the same. So the total weight, if you're building a pack, a bug-out kit with battery, antenna, and radio, then the weight is important. So let's have a look at the key features of this little radio. It has independent TX and RX NRC controls, scan mode, Vox, independent RF and mic gain controls. It has a high cut filter. It has a 7-color display, key beep, and of course, Roger beep with 6 different settings and automatic squelch control. So general radio operation. Everything is controlled through this handset. The power button is the center button here. If you push that button to turn the radio on, you'll see it says CB. Now, CB is a norm, and that is AM, FM, nothing else. If you want to change the norm, push and hold the middle button to turn the radio off. Hold the AF button and the power button, and the radio will turn on in your norm setting mode. You then use the volume key to switch between the norms. And we want to set it to U for UK, so we push and hold the AF key. The radio will reset, and we're now in the UK norm, FM UK. So AF is the button that's used to switch between your frequencies, AM, FM, and FM UK. To access the menu system, you push and hold the EMG button, and that takes you into the relevant menu options. And then here you use the channel up down to move between your menu options. If we want to go to the color, we push EMG again, and then we can switch between the different color options on the display. So we'll keep it as green and then push EMG to accept. So the options we have here is key beep, Roger beep. There are 6 different levels. We have the mic gain control. Scan. We have Vox sensitivity, Vox delay time, RF gain, timeout timer, high cut filter. We have TX noise reduction level settings and RX noise reduction level settings. CTCSS is set in here, and then you have reset. So those are your menu options. So it's a very simple radio to use. It can be a little bit confusing as to when to use the up-down volume as compared to the channel up-down, but you just get used to that. So let's do the standard power test. We're on AM, channel 20. Let's do a carrier test. That's about 3.6 watts. Let's do a tone test. That's about 13.5 watts. Over to FM. .4 watts on FM. And FM UK. About 3.3 watts, 3.2 watts. So that's the standard power tests out of the box. Modifying a radio is at your own risk. You will have legal obligations in your region with regards to radio transmissions, licensing, and power outputs. You should always ensure you are not causing a nuisance and, more importantly, not causing any radio interference or distress to others. Please do not break the law in your region. So let's talk about expansion. How do you expand this radio? Well, there are effectively 4 different modes that you have. It is a little different to normal. The jumper setting here in position 1-2, as it comes out of the box, is standard mode. If the wire is intact, i.e. you haven't cut this wire, then it is just completely standard, 4 watts. If you cut the wire, it remains in CB mode, but does give you increased power output. In CB mode, you get 26.565 to 27.99125 megahertz. Then we move to this jumper, move to position 2-3. So I'm just going to do that now. So that's moved the jumper to bridge 2 and 3. If the wire is intact, then that is HF mode, which is 24.715 to 30.105. And it automatically enables the high power option. You don't have to cut the wire. If you do cut the wire, then the radio goes into ham mode, which is 28 megahertz to 29.695 megahertz. So cutting the wire in CB mode and then moving the jumper over would effectively set you to ham mode. And you would probably want HF mode because you'll get all of your alphas and full range coverage in HF mode. So to modify this radio, don't cut the wire, just move the jumper to position 2-3 and then you'll have maximum coverage. Now that the radio is expanded, let's have a quick look and see what changes that's made. When you push the AF button and the power button to turn it on, it no longer comes up with your norms. You now have your band blocks, and that goes from A all the way through until you get to UK at the end. So the radio will be automatically in block D. Now, if we select that, when you're in the general normal radio operation, as we are now, there is no quick and easy way to switch the band block. If you go to the top channel 40 and then continue, it will just go back to channel 1 in band block D. If you want to switch the blocks, then you have to turn the radio off and hold the 2 buttons and then change the band block to say A, and then it will be in the band block A frequencies. So that's a little bit of a nuisance. There's no quick way to change that. So let's turn it off and just go back to D. Okay, so we've got AM and FM on our mode switch. Now, when we go into the menu, there are 2 new options in the menu. If we cycle through, you now have RF power, and if we select this, we can then switch it to medium and high. So let's have high. And then a bit further on, you'll have -5. So -5K. So that's your 5 kilohertz decrement if you turn that on. And those are the 2 additional menu settings that you get in the menu system. So now we know how to operate the radio. let's go and do the amended high power tests and see what we get. So we're in AM and we are on channel 20 midband. So let's see what we get for a carrier test. We're getting on the carrier 7.7 watts. Let's do a tone test. We're getting about 17 watts there on the tone. Now switching to FM, let's see what we get. About 15.5 watts, and we should test FM UK, but of course that involves having to turn the radio off. And FM UK channel 20, about 14.8 watts or so. So when you're in expanded mode, you also get your alphas. So we're on channel 20 in band block D. If I go down one, we'll have 19 alpha, then 19, and the same at 15, 15 alpha, 15. So it's nice to see that you have alphas supported here as well. Well, what have we learnt? The CS-47 is a very compact radio with a decent power output level in expanded mode. It's fiddly to switch between the band blocks, and using the volume up down on some screens versus the channel up down on others takes a bit of getting used to. The most current it drew during testing was 2.6 amps, and it does get noticeably hot to the touch when transmitting. The CS-47 costs £70 and is the same radio as the Anytone Graces, which costs £95, and the CRT Mic 2, which costs £90. I have mixed emotions with the microphone. On the one hand, it's great that it's all controlled in one place, so the location of the bass unit doesn't really matter. But on the other hand, you can't switch it out and use another microphone if you wanted to or needed to. The expansion is well executed, with the exception of block switching, and includes alphas, a dedicated FM UK block, and supports 5 kHz decrements. If you're looking for a very small, lightweight radio, which supports tones and codes and has NRC, then for £70 it's great value for money. But I would still pick the CB500, which is a better overall radio. Well, I hope you found the information in this video helpful. If you did, then please help the channel out by giving it a thumbs up and subscribing. This really does help to ensure that I can continue to provide content. Please feel free to buy me a coffee. Details are in the description below. And thank you very much to everybody who's bought me one in the past. If you have any questions or comments, then you know what to do. All I ask is that you keep it respectful. Trolls and nasty know-it-alls need not apply. Well, until next time, stay safe, stay happy, and catch you in the next one.